Let's determine some limits graphically. By using the graph of f of x, here in blue, we want to determine the limit as x approaches 2 of f of x. So to determine this limit, we want to know if as we approach x equals positive 2 from both the left side and the right side, are we approaching the same function value? And when we talk about a function value, we're talking about a y value. So I think it's helpful to sketch a vertical line at x equals 2 so we know exactly where we're approaching. We're approaching this vertical line. We're approaching this vertical line x equals 2 along the function from the left side here and the right side. And we want to know if we're approaching the same function value or the same y value. So we can see we're approaching this point here on the function where the function value is equal to negative 3. Therefore the limit as x approaches 2 of f of x is equal to negative 3. Now it is important to make a note that even though f of 2 is equal to negative 3, that does not have to be true in order for this limit to exist. The idea of a limit is as we get closer and closer to positive 2 from both sides, what function value are we getting closer and closer to, not what it's equal to at the x value that we're approaching. Now let's use the same graph to determine a different limit. To determine the limit as x approaches 0 of f of x, we want to approach x equals 0, which is the y-axis from both sides, and see if we're approaching the same function value. So again, we're approaching x equals 0, or this vertical line, along the function from the left and from the right. And again, you can see we're approaching this point here where the function value is equal to positive 1, therefore this limit is equal to positive 1. Let's take a look at two more limits using a different graph. Here we have the limit as x approaches negative 1 of f of x. Well, here's x equals negative 1. And again, we're approaching from the left side and the right side to determine if we're approaching the same function value. And again, you can see we're approaching this point here where the function value is negative 2 from both sides. Therefore, this limit is equal to negative 2. Again, the function value is the y value. And then for this last example, we're approaching positive 2. And notice there is a hole at positive 2, but that does not mean the limit does not exist. So here's our vertical line, x equals 2. And as we approach from the left and from the right, we're getting closer and closer to this point here where the function value is positive 1. Therefore, this limit is equal to positive 1. Even though we can see that at x equals 2, the function does not exist because there's a hole there, the limit does still exist. We'll take a look at several more limits graphically, including one-sided limits and limits at infinity in the next several videos.